Hi, I'm John Hart, and welcome back to Mr. America Hart. Today I'm talking to you about DC, or dog crap training. One of my subscribers asked me if I would do a video just detailing some of my opinion of the different aspects of that program. You can look online and find the program. It's by Dante Trudel, and there's a few aspects of it I'm going to cover rather quickly here, so I'm going to unwrap it as we go right now. The training itself, high-intensity training, rather high frequency of the training of body parts itself. So body parts are trained very short, high intensity in nature, workouts, but also a little bit more frequently, about twice every 8 days or so around. Okay, we can say that. So those are the first two aspects of the training. The third aspect, which I really, really like, is the fascial type stretching. He believes in doing some really good stretching after the body part is fully pumped up. I like this a lot. So right out the gate, I can tell you that the training itself, high intensity in nature, it uses aspects of rest pause after you've gone to failure on approximately 7 to 10 repetitions, and then continuing on after a 10-15 second break, breathing deeply, continuing on with as many reps as you can get with the same weight that you've just used, and then again, take another 10 to 15 second break and then hitting it again a third time. So it's almost like doing three different sets within one. It's a main set to failure and then two other subsets to failure using the same weight. But of course, the repetition is going to be very low at that point because you're going to be fatigued. All of this being said, that top end set, we could call it, that high intensity set is being performed after several warm-up sets that are not taken to failure. So let's not confuse this. Many people consider even a warm-up set, which is nowhere near taken to failure, which is also not even necessarily done for high repetitions, like in the olden days with pyramid-type workouts, where you're doing a warm-up set of 15 repetitions, then a warm-up set with a little bit more weight, and you do 10 repetitions, then a little more weight, and you do 6 repetitions, and then you're ready to go. So that's not what we're talking about here. You do a few warm-up sets, generally, to get the body part warmed up, and then ba-boom, you hit that top end set. I like that a lot. I'm all about the high intensity training. So I like the type of training, the frequency of body parts, twice every 8 days. It's done on an A-B routine, which you'll know, or if you know any of my videos, you've noticed, my subscribers know, that I did a video on the A-B routine, and I'll put the link down in the video description to this video right here so you can go back and review how I split up the body parts on an A-B routine versus how Dante Trudel does. You can go to his website and see exactly how he splits his up or purchase the program from him. But my point here is this. It's an A-B routine, to get big on an A-B routine. Single set training, just like I described. However, he's using a technique which, again, I like rather well. Rest, pause, repetitions, taken to failure. It's great, especially if you're training on your own. Taking an exercise to the point where you've just hit failure, you put the weight down, rest 10 to 15 seconds, taking some good deep breaths, hit it again with the same weight. Rest 10 to 15 seconds, hit it again for a third time. I like that a lot. Frequency of body parts, like I said, it's okay, twice every 8 days. Maybe down the line you want to move that out a little bit further. But for the moment, let's say I like it. And then thirdly, those stretches within the workout itself, after you're done with a certain body part. Wow, I really like these types of things where you're doing stretching, intense stretching with a pumped up body part, especially. That body part is so warmed up that it's hard to injure a joint. You can take those body parts generally further in a stretch than you could ever when they're totally cold. So I like anything that improves our flexibility, and it doesn't really detract, from our recovery ability. If anything, I believe it helps it a little bit. So I like every aspect of the training and DC training. Nutritionally speaking, he does eat carbohydrates. He recommends eating carbohydrates. He front loads them on the front part of the day. And by the way, this is all by my own understanding of his program and my exposure over the years. It's been around for quite a while now. I think it's been about 15 or 20 years. So my exposure to it. I'm coming off the top of my head from what I can recall. Carbohydrates, yes, front loaded on the day. I like that. That's the way I eat pretty much. Later on in the day, less carbohydrates, unless you're training in the evening. But let's just assume you can get that training in the first half of the day. Definitely more carbohydrates in the beginning of the day. Starchy type carbohydrates surrounding that workout or earlier in the day. In the evening, vegetable carbohydrates are okay. Protein intake. He believes in taking in a little bit more protein along the lines of, 2 grams per pound of body weight. So 2 grams per pound of body weight, which is a decent amount of protein right there. So whether you're getting it through your food, your protein drinks, I can see with the amount of damage being done to the muscles that it may be necessary. This is a hypertrophy based type program. So you're going to need a little bit of extra protein in there. So I could roll with getting close to the 2 grams on an experimental basis and then judge it from there. Okay. Cardio, he believes in doing some cardio as well at different times. The cardio itself is being performed on a lower intensity, longer duration type of training. Now, I'm 100% with that. Why is that? You're already doing high intensity training with the weights. So therefore, cardiovascular work does not need to be similar to that weight training. If anything, it needs to be pushed away further in the day, away from the weight training, and then done at a lower intensity so your muscles can continue to repair themselves and recover from the high intensity weight workout that you did. So basically, I look at cardiovascular work as being another activity. It's just increasing your activity levels. So it's not necessarily to go through high intensity interval training type, HIIT, type cardio, but rather a longer duration, slow, moderate, low intensity to moderate intensity type cardio. I'm okay with that as well. The great part that I really like about his training is he involves a certain amount of periodization where you're going through the training for 6, 10, maybe 12 weeks of high intensity training, and everybody, even way back Dorian Yates, during the 90s, he came to admit after he retired even that he wished he had more periods where he'd back off from the training, from going super high intensity all the time. I can relate to him. I'm a switch on or switch off kind of guy. So I understand and relate to him in that regard. Dog crap, that guy Dante has it split so that you train for 6 or 10 or 12 weeks and then you back off for a few weeks, anywhere from, 10 to 21 days, and just do maintenance type workouts. I like this a lot for longevity purposes. This form of periodization really will help and assist in recovery, joint recovery, long-term care of your body. So the high intensity training, the workouts themselves, I like a lot. The diet, I can go almost all the way with them on that as well. The cardio, I like a lot. The stretching in that high intensity training, I like a lot. And then lastly, the periodization, I like a lot. If you can't tell, I like DC training a lot. So that's my evaluation of it. Of course, I've put up the highlights next to me over here, but you can always look online yourself. I'll put the link down below in the video description so that you can find it online as well. So that's it for today. From my heart to you, John Hart, thank you for stopping by. Before you leave, if you're liking the videos that I've been pumping out, down below to your right, you have a red subscribe button. Please give that button a tap off to your left, and you'll get notifications when I have new videos that pop up. And off to your left, you have a thumbs up over there. Please give that video a thumbs up, this video a thumbs up, and I appreciate it. It helps with the channel a lot. Thank you very much.
Hey, do you want John to be your personal trainer? Get your training and diet managed online by Mr. America himself. Go to MrAmericaHeart.com. It's in the link right here below in the video's description.